Today, we're going to learn quicksort. Like merge sort, quicksort is a recursive algorithm. However, when you think of quicksort, I want you to think of the word pivot. A pivot is simply one of the items in the array that meets the following three conditions after we sorted it. First, the pivot is in its correct position in the final sorted array. This means that all items to the left are smaller, and all items to the right are larger. Let's look at an example. We're asked to sort the following array. Let's choose a pivot. I'll explain the best way to do this later, but for now, let's just choose 3. First, we move the pivot to the end of the array to get it out of our way. Next, we're going to look for 2 items. Item from left, which is the first item, starting from the left, that is larger than our pivot. Second, item from right, which is the first item, starting from the right, that is smaller than our pivot. Starting at 2, we can see that 6 is item from left. Now starting at the right, we see that 1 is item from right. Let's swap item from left with item from right. We repeat the process. This time, 5 is item from left, and 0 is item from right. Again, we swap the 2. One more time. This time, we see that item from left has a greater index than item from right, so we know we're done. We swap item from left with our pivot. Three, our pivot, is now in its correct spot. To prove it, let's review our 3 conditions. As you can see, all items to the left are smaller, and all items to the right are larger. We said quicksort is recursive. Let's go through the process one more time with the larger partition we just made. We'll choose 7 as our pivot and move it to the end. I'll let you watch without voiceover. Now we have 3 and 7 in their correct positions. I think you understand the concept, so we'll let recursion handle the rest. One important question is how do we choose the pivot? This makes a large difference in the performance of the algorithm, as we want to choose a pivot that divides the array in half, or as close as possible, to even out the work. One popular method is called median of 3. In this method, we look at the first, middle, and last elements of the array. We sort them properly and choose the middle item as our pivot. We're making the guess that the middle of these 3 items could be close to the median of the entire array, and as you can see, it's not too far off. Here's the pseudocode for quicksort. Quicksort has the worst case time complexity of big O of n squared. But if a pivot is chosen properly, it can be shown to have an average case of big O of n log n. Thank you for watching. Please like and subscribe if you enjoyed the video.